Ever do a screen capture maybe of a demonstration or a video game that you wanted to upscale to 4K, maybe so you can push in and get a little bit more zoom in on a part that you want to highlight? Well, you can do that for free with open source software. I'm going to show you how to do that. Let's go. So the secret to this is something called Video2X. Now, Video2X is open source software that you can get right now from GitHub. All right, so I'm gonna start by showing what it looks like with some still imagery here in terms of the original, which is on the left. That's a 1080p T-Rec from Camtasia, so it's super clean. And on the right, you're seeing the upscaled 4K version through the scaler through Video2X. Now, if I go to 125%, you start to see that it's losing a little bit of resolution in terms of the left-hand side. It's getting a little bit foggy. If you wear glasses, you'll know the look in terms of taking your glasses off, putting them back on for the right-hand side. I'm at 150% right now, and it starts to get even clearer when I go to 175% versus the left-hand side now at 1080p at 175% zoom. Then when I go to 200%, then you can see a big difference in terms of the left and right side. But just for fun, I thought I'd also take it up another notch beyond the 200%. Because what I wanted to really see was what it looked like at about 400%. So there you can see at 400%, we're really losing a lot of sharpness on the left-hand side. You can start to see the pixels pretty easily on the left-hand side. And if you go up even more than this to 800% right now, you'll see that there's even more pixelation visible on the left-hand side. So you get this big difference between what's on the left and what's on the right if you want to zoom in or push into some detail on your recordings. Now, there are some downsides to this. So when I record the two screens, I'm just going to show them side by side, and I'll explain how this works in a minute. As you can see with the scrolling, they're not both as smooth as one another. So on the left, this is the native T-Rec file from Camtasia, so it's scrolling very smoothly, and they're both at 200% zoom at the moment. You can see the right-hand side, yes, the text and everything does look a lot cleaner, but you know, there's a little bit of choppiness in terms of the motion. So then if I continue to look through the different tabs here, in this case on the demo, you'll see the right-hand side is just a lot cleaner. And you know, for a recorded screen, especially something like this where it's focused on text recorded from the browser, it's looking much, much nicer on the right-hand side at 4K. So one thing to point out though, here I've taken some video, and you can see that with video, and you see it sometimes also on the screen recording, there'll be artifacting. So this artifacting will show up occasionally on your video, and this is something to be aware of after you've converted it. So just in terms of where to get it, on GitHub at the link on the screen, you can get to the GUI version and the command line version for PC. And that will take you to the right areas online in terms of where you can download the packages. This is what the user interface looks like that I'll show you in a second when we convert a file. But it's pretty easy to use. Some of the sources online say that it's all command line interface, but there is a GUI for it, a graphical user interface that you can get to. And you know, when you click on that, you can see that it's at version 4.8.1. And there you can get to the Win32 package, and it is 1 gigabyte exactly, 1,000 megabytes, which is kind of odd. But you can see the package is from December 29th, 2020. So when you download it, what it's gonna do is download a zip file. And so once you extract everything, what you'll get is a folder that looks like this. Now, these are the different files that you'll use to open. So the GUI.exe is the one that you'll use to open the actual upscaler. This is the command line that you can use as a console app effectively. And then the output folder, well, this is important to know about because if you convert multiple files in a batch at one time, they'll actually go into this output location, not into the location where the originating file is. So you'll need to know this because you might lose files if you do a batch conversion of multiple different MP4s, for example. They will show up in that output folder. So once you launch it, this is what it looks like. So here I've got the GUI. The GUI's version 2.8.1. You can select a file, a folder. You need to clear all of the files if you do one at a time. And so here I'm going to go ahead and move to the folder where I've got a file that's ready for conversion. So I'll select my file. And now what that's going to do is it's basically going to put an MP4 in. and it's going to output it with the same file name and the same location with underscore output. Now let's reverse engineer a little bit in terms of how this works and probably why you saw some of the choppiness in terms of the scroll. So what you can do is you can copy the cache folder location, which is an app data folder. And these folders are only created during the conversion process. If I paste this in here, you'll see that it's got two different folders. Now, in one folder, you'll have the original images. So everything in the video gets extracted as a PNG file. This one is 1920 by 1080, as is this one. In fact, everything in this folder is 1920 by 1080. And it's creating a PNG for every single frame. So know that if you're going to convert a 60 FPS video, it will take twice as long as a 30 FPS video. But if you go back to the folder and then you go into the second one, you'll notice that all of these ones are actually 4K native images, 3840 by 2160. So what it's going to do then is basically convert image by image, frame by frame, every single frame in that video. Then it's going to recompile them back onto its own sequential timeline and then reapply the audio to it in order to create that 4K version. So this one, for example, takes about an hour and a half on my machine. It might be faster if you've got a more powerful machine. I do have a discrete GPU, but it is a laptop. So then when the upscaling is finished, you'll see that in this case, it took about an hour and 40 minutes or something to complete. And what that's gonna create is that underscore output.mp4 file of the same file name. And when you go to play that, this is now a 4K version of the video that was originally 1080p. And here, when you look at it, because this is kind of more text-based screen recording content, you don't really see anything in terms of choppiness from a scrolling motion. If anything, so the downscaling, because I'm playing a 4K video, was the only thing that you really see that's slightly different than the native 4K, because I'm playing a 4K video through VLC player that's getting downscaled to fit as a smaller than 1080p screen effectively because of the chrome of the app, so that it's actually clean when you watch it in 4K, as we saw in the zoomed version of the video from before. So that was Video2X, something that you can get for free on GitHub right now with a GUI around it for Windows. If you like this tip, be sure to give me a like. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel for more tips like this. Check out my entire Demo Like a Pro series. The whole playlist is on the screen right now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.